In a previous video, we got serious. We built Pooch Pal, a fully autonomous customer service agent for a dog grooming business using Microsoft Copilot Studio. It was powerful, but let's be honest, it took a little bit of work to set up. Today, I want to show you the fast lane. We're going to build a new agent that reads and responds to emails in about 3 minutes. Let's say you have a restaurant. You also take the time to help people with cooking ideas. So we're going to build an AI sous chef. The goal, you email random ingredients sitting in your fridge and it searches allrecipes.com to email back a perfect 5-star dinner recipe instantly. We're going to be using the new Microsoft Copilot workflow agent to do it. No coding, no complex nodes. Let's get cooking. Hi everyone, I'm Jamie and welcome to Teachers Tech. If you watched the Pooch Pal video, you saw me using Copilot Studio. This is the heavy-duty tool for enterprise bots. Today we're using Workflows Agents. Think of this as the Lite version. It's right inside your standard Copilot chat, and it's designed to automate your personal tasks, whether that be answering business emails, or in this case, figuring out what's for dinner. To get to Microsoft 365 Copilot, all you need to do is go to office.com and log into your account. You can see where you can sign up for a free version as well. So go ahead, get signed in, and we'll go from there. Once you're logged in, you'll be on the new chat page. If you've never logged into Microsoft 365 Copilot like this before, I have a whole video explaining what all this is. But for this video, where we're going to go to is agents, and I want to go to all agents. And this is where, if I scroll down a bit, I have Workflows Agent right here. If you don't see this, you can do a search, just type in Workflows and it should pop up. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on this and then we just need to go ahead and click Add. After a few seconds, it pops up right here. Quick heads up before we build, you might see the tag Frontier in Microsoft terms. This just means early access. To follow today, you need two things, a commercial Microsoft 365 Copilot license. Your IT must have preview or Frontier features enabled. The most important part of any AI agent is telling it where to get its information. I don't want my sous chef to hallucinate a recipe that tastes terrible. I want it to use a trusted source. So in our prompt, we're going to explicitly tell it to go to allrecipes.com. You could pick another. We're not dragging and dropping notes today. We're just typing instructions in plain English. I need to set up three things. The trigger, a specific subject line, so it doesn't reply to all my work emails. The action, search all recipes for a highly rated dish. And the response, email me instructions immediately. Now, I'm just gonna walk through this. So here's the first part. When a new email comes into my inbox and the subject line reads chef help. Remember, I don't want it to answer all my emails. So just when the subject line has this in it. Read the ingredients or requests listed in the email, research a highly rated recipe, and I'm telling it to go to allrecipes.com, reply using an email directly to the sender, make sure the email is formatted in HTML, respond in a friendly, helpful chef's manner, and write as if you were replying to the sender's email. So this is important part of the formatting on how the email looks and everything. So I'll talk a little bit more. We'll add some changes as we go along to it, how to edit it. For each section of the recipe, start a new paragraph and write a detailed response. The more verbose, factual, the better. Sign off with Bon Appetit, your AI sous chef. So let's go ahead and send this. So now I can see that it has started with a trigger. So the new chef help email. So that's the first part. And we can kind of follow along the workflow over here. It looks like it's going to be 4 steps. It's going to go extract the ingredients or request. So, and then it's going to go to research the recipes on all recipes. And then it's going to go reply with a recipe email. So what I'm going to do now, and this is an important step, we're going to go to save. Now, notice there is a test, but what I'm going to do is jump over to an email and we'll go ahead and send this. Okay, so here's the email I'm going to send. This is one of my demo accounts here, but this is what this is where my Microsoft 365 Copilot is hooked to. We have in the subject, chef help. Remember, that was the important part here. Hi there, I'm stirring my fridge. We have no idea what to make for dinner. I have the following ingredients. Can you find me a highly rated recipe? Okay, so you get the point. I'm gonna go ahead and send this. Now, let's check a few things out now. I have activity. If I check on it, I can see that it ran for 42 seconds here and it succeeded. I'm gonna go, if I click on this, it will show kind of the step-by-step what happened. We'll check it in my real email in a moment. So we saw the email arrive, I saw the boneless chicken, using the ingredients recipes. They extracted the ingredients and they replied to it. So let's see how everything looks here. I'm going to go over to my Outlook. Here's the email right here. I can already see that it was replied to. I haven't opened this yet, so I'm just going to click on it. And here was the original email. I'm just going to go click up here. So thank you for reaching out. So dear chef in training, thank you for reaching out. As your helpful AI sous chef, you can go through the recipe name, creamy chicken with spinach, ingredients, kind of a nice format here to instructions. I'll go just jump over to my email that I sent it from so we can look at it from there. And here we go. So this one is reply to a Gmail address and we can see everything is in there the same. So that is a very easy setup to get an email response that was searched for, but I'm going to show you how you can modify this as well. Okay, so here I am back in my workflows here in the same place. I'm going to give it a message to make a change to it. The one thing I want to mention, the formatting came out not bad on this one, but I've been working with the formatting so that it was in before I asked it to do a numbered list. It did it automatically this time, so it was remembering what I've asked it to do in previous test of it, but I actually had to go through and almost give it other instructions sometimes to make sure you use numbered list where appropriate, the HTML formatting. So all these things, if your formatting's not getting corrected, just kind of play around with it and giving it specific instructions. So this time I'm going to say, add a link to the recipe you selected. And I'm just going to send this off. So just to show you how we can modify this. Okay, you can see it's red here. It looks like it made changes. When it makes the changes, you need to make sure you go save it. Now, this is an error that I came up with when using links, and I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to go resend the email, and then we'll just jump back over to the email. So I just sent the exact same email. You can see under activity, now we have two. I'm just going to go over to the email, and this was the response. So it was the exact same question. And at the bottom here, we have this creamy garlic chicken with spinach. So a link, but when I click on this, you can see, oops, this isn't it. It's at the right site, all recipes, but it doesn't go anywhere. And I've done this a few different times with a few different links and I still get broken links. And I try to get it to do YouTube videos and different things. I had it work for a channel, but not specific videos. So I don't know if I'm prompting this wrong. If you have an idea with this, how maybe in the prompt that it could get fixed, makes me a little worried with some of the information too. So remember I told you about some issues. This is something I wouldn't just set up to run automatically without checking responses, because I'm not 100% sure if it's pulling all from the right place, even though it says it is. Now you can keep adapting just by having that conversation with it. It will update any of the workflow and then you just have to save it again. If I go back, I'm going to open up the panel and let's say I'll click on researcher here and then I'm going to click back on workflows and you think it's gone, but these different workflows get saved right here. The thing is, if you have multiple workflows, and this is why the subject heading would matter, I could have multiple emails, replying to emails multiple times if I had multiple workflows, because you can have more of these than just the one. And if you go over here, you'll notice that you can turn it off or delete it. If you want to go back in it, we can just click on it and it's going to go ahead and open back up again where you can make some edits to this. Now, I want to be 100% transparent with you about this tool. In my previous Pooch Pal video using Copilot Studio, connecting to my internal OneDrive or uploading documents like price list and FAQs worked flawlessly. However, while testing this new workflow agent, I couldn't really get it to read internal documents to form a knowledge base. That's why for this demo, I chose to use a public website like allrecipes.com because the agent can do that searching. If you build an agent for your business and it can't find the file you linked, it might try to be helpful by guessing an answer. You don't want an AI guessing your prices or making up a cancellation policy for your client. So here's my best advice. Even though I showed you how to send auto replies today, don't start there. In your prompt, instead of going reply directly, I would say create a draft email. This puts the email in your drafts first, allows you to spend 5 seconds reviewing it to make sure the information is accurate and the tone is right. You still save the time of writing it, but you keep the human in the loop until you're 100% confident that the agent is reading your files correctly. This is the safest way to automate. I hope this video gave you a little bit of insights on what's coming with agents and how they're going to help you automate to save you a lot of time, but remembering to make sure you check things over first. Thanks for watching this time on Teacher's Tech. I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.